Hi! In this video, you will learn how to add an image gallery with the slideshow feature to a page and set it up. In the Tilda block library, you'll find multiple blocks with different gallery designs. All of these blocks are set up in a more or less same way. Let's take the first, GL01 block, as an example. Let's say I'm creating a website for a photography studio. To show the portfolio, I'm going to add a slideshow gallery block to the page. You can find this block, GL01, in the gallery category. To add my images, I open the Content tab of the block. By default, there are a couple of demo images here. Let me quickly delete them by clicking the trash can button next to the images. Now, to upload my own images, I click Upload Files. It's totally possible to upload several images at once. I can drag and drop the files or select them from the desktop, then click Upload Selected and save changes to see what they look like. To replace the image uploaded before, click Replace Image in the Content tab and upload a new file in the pop-up window. Let me just pick an image from my desktop. Here it is. Now I save the changes and make sure the image was uploaded to the gallery. To change the order of images, hover over the image in the Content tab and drag it up or down. After setting the order you want, save the changes and see what the gallery looks like. To have the images indexed by search engines, in Google Images for example, let's add the alt tag for SEO. I open the Content tab, then click on the Text button and type the text in the Image Alt for SEO field. I'll type Family Portrait Photography Studio Dublin as an example. This text will not be visible to the visitors, its purpose is only to help search engine robots understand what the photo is about. In the same section, you can also specify the image title and description that will be displayed under the image, as well as choose the text position using the Align option. Let me add Fashion Photography as the image title, save the changes, and check the title display. If you want to use a video in the gallery, you can do that. Click the Video button and add a link to YouTube or Vimeo or a link to the MP4 file in your server. I have a YouTube video, so I just paste the URL in the YouTube Video ID field. Then save changes and check how the video looks in the preview mode. Let's go back to the editor. Now let's take a look at the settings tab of the gallery block. Here I can resize the gallery block using the width and height parameters. Let me change the width to 10 columns and the height to 500 pixels. I save the changes and check what it looks like. The image stretch parameter allows you to resize the photos within the gallery. There are three options to choose from. First one allows you to keep the original size of the image. Second one makes it possible to fit the image to the block without cropping it. And the third one adjusts the width and height of the image to the block ratio, which means the image may get cropped. I'll keep the default value for this parameter. The zoom image on click box allows you to switch to a magnified view of the image after clicking on it on the published page and better see all of the details in the picture. In the gallery style tab, I can set the display of control elements in the gallery style. For example, you can change the style and position for the arrows and dots and set the autoplay slideshow in the gallery. Let me select only arrows as control elements and assign the arrow position inside the image. Save the changes and see what it looks like. As you can see, dots are gone. And the arrows are now displayed right on the image. In the Description tab, I can change how the text is displayed. For example, select the font size and color for the image title and description and set the alignment. Let me set the title font size to 24 pixels and align it to the center. Click Save Changes and check the image title display. In the Animation tab, you can enable and disable animation effects displayed on the published page. I'll select the fade-in effect here and save changes. To keep the unity on the page, it's a good idea to adjust the spacing between blocks or padding. I'll set the padding at the top and at the bottom. The block background color allows me to specify the background color for the block if required. I'll keep the default value here. Once I'm done with the settings, I save the changes, then publish the page, and check how the gallery is displayed on the published page. The arrows allow switching between the photos. The video works as well. My slideshow gallery is done and published on the website. Thanks for watching and good luck in creating wonderful websites. Bye!